Neighborhood where I've done a lot of business for years. I'm outside the Brazilian Smoke cigar shop where I had just made a purchase. And walking out, I accidentally dropped my money and didn't realize until I got to 7-Eleven to make a payment. I immediately dashed back to the store, asked the manager working there, and he said no, he didn't see it. But it was dropped right outside the store, and he has a surveillance camera there. And the guy was in the store, had a wad of cash resembling the exact amount, 70-some-odd dollars that I dropped, the 320s, five and singles. No, it was actually more than that. I can go back and do an accounting. I think it was at least 70, closer to 100. And he made some snide remark, oh, you drop it, you lose it here in Venice. I said, no, I'm not going to lose it. I retraced my steps back. I went through every bag, every pocket. And he then came out and smugly went in front of the 7-Eleven, made a smug remark, and went in, made purchases, and pulled out again what looked like my money in the exact way I had it rolled up in my pocket. So then I said, are you sure you didn't see it? And he made some other snide remark. Then went in the store at 7-Eleven, apologized I wasn't able to make a purchase because someone grabbed my money. Went back out to him and said, hey, sir, if that is my money, there's surveillance cameras. I'm going to have them pulled. If you took my money, you're committing a crime. I'm letting you know it's my money. And he threatened to assault me and started calling me snide remarks. And he appeared to be a homeless male. In his late 50s or 60s, he had on a red plaid jacket, a backpack, probably about 5'10", wiry. I've never seen him before around here. I went back and talked to the manager. He said there are surveillance cameras. He doesn't have the password, but police detectives could get it from his manager. And it's right here on Venice, next to the 7-Eleven, northeast of Venice and Sepulveda. The 7-Eleven is 11-143, so this address over here is getting, and across the street is Du Fresnin, 3700 South Venice Boulevard on the north side, which is LAPD jurisdiction. Smoke shop in strip mall. I don't see any hamburgers at the strip mall here. But it's right next to the Baskin Robbins and the Coin Laundry. And he has a surveillance camera that covers that parking lot up there. And there's a surveillance camera here. So the money was dropped in this parking lot. There's the BKK 101 Thai Cuisine. There's also surveillance video. There's enough surveillance video covering this parking lot, including 7-Eleven. That whoever picked it up, that can be identified. And everybody in the parking lot area knew I was looking for my money that I just dropped. And I really needed my money since I'd been robbed multiple times this week alone. And I really needed that money to survive until I get all my back money, which has been delayed due to identity theft and jackasses. Criminals with badges. My last 3 days have been a living hell. The last week and a half, 2 weeks, pretty much the last two or three months have been a nightmare because for some reason my checks are being returned to U.S. Treasury when they're being sent to an address at a federal building where I have been getting my stuff for years. So, if I were that guy who I think took my money, I would pray to hell it's not yours because you have now committed a felony with your criminal threats and knowingly stealing my money. I can go down a list of why I'm going to have your ass in prison for this if I need to. But clearly, I do want this investigated by LAPD. And don't keep pulling me over and finding reasons to wear handcuffs on me or going out of your way to stretch and then say I'm going to get a felony when I'm the victim. The chances of you hitting me with a felony that you'll get to stick, you have a better chance of burning something on Teflon, bitch. So stop fucking with me, you crooked cops and you gangsters on the street, because I'm going to start lowering hammers you don't even know I have in my possession, and it's going to hurt real bad when I stomp your ass into a fucking prison.